Good evening, everyone. I'm Steve from UCAN English Tutoring. I'm going to assess one of my students' OET letter in this role play, video, and then provide the word-by-word feedback along with the feedback against each criteria, and finally the overall score for this letter. Before we jump onto the assessment, I would like to provide a gentle reminder in regards to the membership programs I run on my YouTube channel. If you become a member, you should be able to access all the members-only videos containing A grade and B grade letters, A grade and B grade role play conversations, 8-band and 7-band essays, reports, and letters for the IELTS exam, and 90-scorer speaking answers and essays, you know, for the PT academic examination. Let's start the assessment now. Okay, so you have written on the date on the top. That's good. Your handwriting looks good. It looks neat and tidy. So that's really good. The nurse supervisor, rehabilitation unit, Bankstown Hospital, Chapel Road, Bankstown, New South Wales, 2200. This is close to where I live in anyway, this Bankstown. All right. Okay. Let's go to this one. Dear nurse supervisor, that's good. I'm happy with that. That's all right. Reference details, you have written on the reference details. After that, Miss Mary Daniel, aged 75. That's really good. I'm happy with that. I am writing to request ongoing monitoring and care for Miss Mary Daniel. That's good. Happy with that. She underwent, you know, as I already told, you know, this U, you know, the way you write on this U sounds like a capital letter. You need to change it to the small u, isn't it? So you have to write down like this, okay? Okay, so she underwent, can you tell me what this one is? Is that an?
Yes, sir.
Now you don't need to use an surgical repair, it's wrong. You can use urge surgical repair, it's an is wrong because we don't need to use and in front of the words, you know, that do not create the vowel sound. So, and surgical repair should be replaced with the surgical repair, okay? All right, so please understand this one and avoid it maybe next time, okay? A surgical repair of the right leg following a fracture. Okay, that's fine. She's being discharged today. That's fine. So I'm happy with that. So there are no major mistakes in the introduction paragraph. I'm happy with that. Let's go through the next one. Miss Danielle is single. She has a history of diabetes mellitus since 2000, which has been controlled by, this is the name of the medication, isn't it? Dawanil, right? 10 mg twice a day. That's really good. Yeah. So I'm happy with this paragraph as well. It's really good. There's no issue over there. So Miss Daniel, so write down N properly as well, you know, so you should write down properly N as well, you know. So Miss Daniel was admitted to hospital for the surgery. Okay, you don't need to use the surgery because surgery shouldn't require any article before that. Unless it is the name of a surgery. Okay, if it is a specific surgery, then you can write down the and then whatever it is, the shoulder surgery, for example. Okay, the hip surgery, that's okay. But for just surgery, we shouldn't use any preposition. Okay, that is uncountable noun. So the surgery should be replaced with the surgery only. Okay. I hope that clarifies your doubt. Okay, right. Let's go ahead with that. On 30 May, which was uneventful. That's good. Post-operatively, okay. As I already said, you know, the R can be written out a bit clearly. Okay, so it's not that good, okay. Post-operatively, she was started physiotherapy and Panadine 6-hourly for her pain. Okay, so what you could have done, okay, there's a better way of writing down the passive voice form. Instead of writing down like this, you could have said, post-operatively, comma, a physiotherapy and Panadine 6-hourly for pain, where started or where commenced, okay? That could have been much better, okay? All right. Yeah, that would have been much better, right? Let's go ahead with the next one. Her recovery was delayed due to, again, this U must be written on clearly. So this one sounds like the capital U, you know, This is how it looks like. You should look like this. You should write down U, you know, not in the capital letter. All right. Let's go ahead with the next one. Okay. Due to high blood glucose level. Okay, that's all right. Therefore, she was commenced on intravenous fluid with insulin therapy and vanadium. That's all right. She is bedridden. She's bedridden and has had a pressure ulcer. Okay, for which applying, sorry, what is this? Can you tell me this? I think this is wrong.
Applying.
It's applying, right? But where is why? Why is missing? And the other issue is, okay, the whole sentence is incorrect. Okay, I'll write down one by one. So you should have placed a comma after for which, okay? For which, and then there should be a comma. And then let's go through that. Okay, she is bedridden and has had a pressure ulcer for which applying normal saline dressing for the same. Okay, no, this is wrong. Okay, so what you should have done is that you should have mentioned like this. Okay, she has and has had a pressure ulcer for which normal dry saline dressing has been applied, isn't it? So has been applied. No, normal dress something for the same. Okay, let's say which applying. Okay, applying. It's applying only. Okay, applying should have been removed. Okay, remove this from here. So you just need to remove. So after for which we are going to have only saline dressing. Okay, it's normal saline dressing. Okay, instead of writing down for the same, you can say. All the same can be replaced with the has been applied. Okay, that would have been much better. And then you have to put a full stop after that anyway. So this could have been more appropriate. Do you understand what I mean?
Yes, sir.
Okay, all right, let's go to the next one. The next page is, okay, you've got this one. She has permanent indwelling urinary catheter. Okay. Catheter is a countable noun. So you should have used, she has, permanent. All right. So instead of saying she has, you should have mentioned she has a permanent catheter, whatever the, you know, the information you have got, you just need to use it. Okay. Catheter due to incontinence of urine. Okay. Currently she is on 1,500 calorie diabetes mellitus diet. Okay. That's all right. That's okay. All right. Next one is upon discharge, comma, monitoring blood glucose level on daily basis. Let's say if it is a frequency, okay, for example, that started on daily, on weekly, and so on, we need to use a or an, depending on the phrase that you use after that. For example, it's going to be on a daily basis, okay, on a daily basis. For example, on a weekly basis, okay. Or you can say on a monthly basis and so on. So this is how on a monthly basis and so on. So this is what you have to do. Okay. So it is going to be on a daily basis. All right. If you feel you may commit these kinds of mistakes again, it's better to avoid it and write down maybe daily. That's it. You don't need to mention on a daily basis. Is this clear with you?
Yes, sir.
So you can say, otherwise you can say, you know, regular monitoring or daily monitoring blood glucose level daily is highly beneficial. Okay, that can be written down. Beneficial for Ms. Daniel. Okay. Kindly provide dressing management of pressure ulcer and catheter care along with the administer medications, okay, for her. Okay, let's say along with the administration of medications, because you have been using only the nouns here, isn't it? Dressing, management of something, catheter care, all these things are the nouns only, but you have written on a verb here, which is not correct, isn't it? Along with the administration of medications, that would be more appropriate. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
So, along with, okay, let's say administer medications. So what you could have done is you could have mentioned along with administration of medications. Okay, that could have been more appropriate. Sorry, yeah. I type, I do commit mistakes when I type, sorry. Okay, yep, administer, okay, for her. She requires assistance in daily living activities. Okay, assistance in activities of daily living, that's okay, assistance, that's fine, yeah. If you have any questions, please do not hesitate to contact me. Yours faithfully, the charge nurse. So we don't know the name of the address, isn't it? So you have used yours faithfully, that's fine. It's not that bad, it is okay, it's not that bad. Okay, all right, let's go ahead with the assessment. Okay, one is, all right, grammar needs to be improved a lot because you have committed a lot of grammatical mistakes. Most of these mistakes are coming under grammar. All right, that's one thing. Particularly, you know, use of articles, that's one thing, because you haven't used you know, the articles and you have used incorrectly, you know, the and other things. So use of articles is one of the major problems. Okay, and then the prepositions as well, prepositions, and then the nouns and verbs needs to be improvised. You should improve on all these areas. Okay, right, spelling is another problem. Another problematic area. You have to focus on your spelling also because you have committed a couple of spelling mistakes, right? Write down the letters, you know, write down the capital and small letters. Write down the capital and small letters clearly. Okay, you are not using that. For example, this one, you know, U, capital U is used instead of small u. Okay, also r, small r, is not correctly written down, so that's not good. So these things need to be avoided. All right, layout and presentation are fair enough. I'm happy with those things. You were able to give enough spacing, so they're all really good. Vocabulary, they have been a bit better with the use of synonyms and formal phrases. Okay, that could have been done. Connectivity is all right. It's not that bad. I'm happy with the connectivity. Overall, task fulfillment is okay. It's good as well. Passive voice form could have been used more appropriately and more frequently. Okay, could have been used more frequently and appropriately. Okay, that could have been done. What else? Let me see here. Use of range of sentence structures is up to the mark. I'm happy with the way that you have been using a range of sentence structures. Okay, so everything else has been good enough, has been looking good, and in one instance you haven't you know, used the passive voice form properly. You said she has been started physiotherapy and so on, isn't it? So that could have been rewritten. Okay, so looking at all these things, I wouldn't be happy to give you 300, but I can give you somewhere close to 300. Okay, to me, you know, this sounds like a 280 out of 500 letter. Should be able to get you at least 280 out of 500 letter. All right. I hope the assessment has been helpful to you. Thank you so much. Take care.